steadfast commitment to his decision in Brown versus Board of Education. Very volatile time in our country's history dealing with segregation. No doubt that was a very unpopular decision for a large portion of the country. And as the DA, I've been making decisions for the past 7 years, and not all of them have been popular, but they've been in furtherance of my oath to see that justice is done. So I commend him. I align myself with his ability to make decisions that are not necessarily popular, but they're right. Ms. Brumbelow?
Because I believe they have strict interpretation of the Constitution. And I believe that they know what conservative values are and represent what the Republican Party stands for. So I believe in their judicial philosophies, and I believe that that's something that I would bring to the bench.
Well, you guys are pick one, she picked two. Can't say much else about that.
All right, in our closing statements, the first will be Mr. Martin. Ms. Brumbelow. Ms. Brumbelow, you'll have your closing statement first, and then Mr. Martin. 1 minute.
I thank you so much for being here tonight. I know that all you had something else better to do, but I can't articulate how much it means to have your support here tonight, regardless of whether you support myself or you support my opponent. Most people don't realize the hard work and long hours that you put into a candidacy. And I thank you so much for being here. And well, the one thing I want to say is I'm the only candidate that had the most diverse legal background here to handle any case that could come before the district court. I have had 20 years worth of experience, and 17 of which I've been licensed for. I thank you so much if I earned your vote the first time, and I ask you to encourage you to vote for me again. If I earned your vote today, or earned your vote since our last election, I definitely appreciate that as well. If I haven't had the opportunity to earn your vote, please see me back. More than happy to explain my Fifth Amendment right that my opponent wants to harp on and explain to you what the Fifth Amendment really means. And I encourage everybody to please go and vote Tina Brumbelow May 14th through the 18th at Old City Hall in Canton, and also at your consolidated block, which I can explain to you back on May the 22nd.
Being here tonight, I want to earn your vote. I want you to elect me because you like me, because you believe in me, because you believe in the service that I provided to Zandt. And I don't want you to vote for me because you don't align with Ms. Brumbelow. I want to get the job. I want to get the job because I'm within the system. I want to promote from within. I want to use the experience that I've garnered over the last 14 years of county government. As I said before, I know the ins and the outs. I know budget. I know relationships. I know the defense bar. I know the family bar. I know the community. I know where the drug havens are. I've got the judicial discernment to look at facts and know what's going on behind the scenes. Okay? Zandt County is my home. It's your home. It's where I raise my kids. It's where you raise your kids. I raise your kids. I want to make a continuing impact on that. I've got specific, unique qualifications to fulfill this job. I didn't show up in November to put my name on the ballot and win. This is something I've done through prayerful consideration. And you know what? Win or lose, it does not matter, because I have faith that God's going to put me where He wants to put me. I would love to have your vote. I would love to have your consideration. If you want more information from me, I'll be here.